Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Yeah.
Here are all of cards. Sorry.
Okay, which one
is Anne? She is the president
of
Global Union.
And you?
And I'm international secretary in PUM.
All right.
Excuse me for waiting because we are meeting a plenary meeting session here. Yeah.
Okay, the plenary meeting is it's ongoing.
But now it's already over. Okay. Finish.
All right. Busy day.
Busy day. And after. At one, we have a fraction meeting.
Okay.
So, jadi kedatangan mereka datang ke sini.
Mungkin bahasa Inggris saja biar mereka.
We are from the Uni Global Union family. Yeah.
Yep.
This is the president, comprised of 20 million union members.
Okay.
And the affiliate in Indonesia is Aspek Indonesia.
Aspek. Yeah. Okay.
Mensa is the president and
Aspek
is the general secretary. Yeah.
Okay.
We are more on the service sector.
Yes. Okay.
The skilled workers also is under our jurisdiction.
So,
we came here because you are in the union movement and also.
I was.
So then maybe we can. Have a discussion, maybe and explore the possibility of maybe collaboration or others. Because our aim is to bring upwards the welfare of the workers.
Okay.
Yes, and also protect the rights of the workers and so on. So we need the parliament also to help.
See.
Yeah, in order that the regulations should pro to the workers as well. And then you came here because you are. The movement since and activist since Suharto times. You have been in jail and then you have a lot of experience. You are senior in the people movement, yeah. So that's why maybe we can discuss sharing and others. Yeah.
Okay, thank you Pak Kun for introducing me to Miss Anne and Miss Joseta from the union and Ibu
Mira.
Okay. I've been accompanied by Dina. Dina is my staff here, and she was also in the movement, also still in the movement, workers movement. And then thank you for visiting us. And actually, yes, I was in the movement, peasants and the union movement. And now currently I'm joining the commission too. Nothing directly connected with. Union movement now, dealing mostly in the local government and village government in Indonesia,
okay.
Home affairs, internal affairs committee
yes.
In the parliament, but still the problem of the union, mostly in the service or manufacturing sector, still there. And then actually Dina also recently mendaftarkan
registering
law from representing the union about what law?
It's the
dispute settlement. Okay. Yeah, representing the union. Dispute settlement. And then also now in Indonesia we have some social security scheme for formal workers or informal ones, non-informal sectors. And then we try to collaborate with the BPJS. BPJS apa yang
biasa? The insurance provider.
Insurance provider, state-owned, state administered insurance provider in Indonesia for social security. And then we hope that we can provide collaboration, because mainly I'm focusing now more on the village issues, village development issues and rural development. And then it is very connected with also the issue of the workers, because in the next 5 or 10 years we will see the emerge or the rise of the workers movement in the rural areas, because we now trying to set up a sort of what we call village-owned enterprises owned by the villagers, and then we will absorb a lot of job to create job for the people, and then we will see that in the rural areas also the issue of the workers issue will be there, and then we will anticipate for the immerse the rise of the service sectors in the rural areas.
Well, thank you very much for taking time off your busy schedule accepting us us here. We're, as Kun was saying, we're in the same global family.
Okay. Yes, right.
So Uni Global Union is the biggest international trade union, global trade union in the world. Mostly service workers from all walks of life. And Sister Mira here is also in the executive, and yeah, and now also the chair of the president of the UNIAPRO African Pacific Region's Women's Committee. So yes, we have relations in that sense, and also bilateral relations we have with my union, PAM in Finland, and ASPEC Indonesia since 2009.
Okay.
So we know each other pretty well. And we have very common goals. And that's what we like to do in the international trade union movement. We like to be a part of societies, also nationally as well as internationally. So internationally we work with different economic organizations like the World Bank, the WTO, we try to influence the G20 meetings and such, where things that matter in workers' life are dealt with. So we need to be present in those places. Nationally, we promote organizing. We would like more and more workers to join the unions, to get stronger unions, to give a good voice.
Including the one who works in the small and medium enterprises as well.
Yes. Those are usually the people who would need us most, isn't it?
Yes,
the people who are worst off. So yes, we would like to include everybody. So in that sense, we see that nationally, the unions need to have a voice too. They need to be a part of building the societies. We're talking about social security, dispute settlements, all that. We have a problem with union busting. We have problems with people not getting paid enough. We have all these issues that we want to address in every part of our national governments as well. And in that sense, we stand together globally. And we're trying to make the voice better. Of course, we're in a very different situation in different countries in the world. And that's why we're...
And Finland is one of the most unionized society in the world. Finland, one of the most unionized society in the world.
We, in the whole country, the density is it was around 70% of the workers.
And mostly are unionized.
And over 90% of workers are covered by collective agreements. So we know that the right to negotiate and the right to get collective agreements is the answer for bettering people's lives. And we know that those companies all over the world, where the companies understand that it's reasonable, it's wise to work together with the workers and to secure their rights, the companies are doing, the business is doing better. That is obvious. In those societies where unions are recognized and they have a voice, also the distribution of wealth is in a better place. So the whole societies benefit from
the whole society, not only the workers. I know.
As we say, we like to be a part of the solution, not the problem.
I know.
Yes, and in that sense, ASPEC is working very hard here in Indonesia. And as Kun was saying,
service sectors actually is very, you know,
it's huge
everywhere, huge, omnipresent.
Growing.
Much bigger than the manufacturing sectors,
Even in the future.
Mostly in the, during the digital economic era.
Three sectors.
Digital economic era.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, it's predicted that in the next 10 years, yes. 90% of okay, all new jobs will come to services sector. Okay. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes, 90%.
So these guys here make a difference, and I'm sure they have a message for you that okay. how you could enhance the collaboration
yes.
Between the parliament and the government and the and the unions. So
si,
I'm sure Sister Mira, she can have a important message for you.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah, Mas Budiman, terima kasih banyak.
Sorry.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Thank you. I have a question. Yeah. Thank you, Mas Budiman.
Sudah mau meluangkan waktu di kesibukan Mas Budiman. Kami tahu ini waktu hari Jumat dengan sholat Jumat sangat sempit. Tapi kami sejak tanggal 27 April sampai tanggal 2 Mei menemani Anselin untuk mengunjungi beberapa tempat seperti Kementerian Tenaga Kerja dan juga Parlemen dan kami Mas Budiman dan juga beberapa anggota Aspek Indonesia. Ada beberapa hal kemungkinan jadi kami adalah Aspek Indonesia Federasi Servis Sektor Jasa. Ini sekjen saya, Sabda.
Kalau
saya ajak dulu ke
kita diskusi mau bikin film dokumenter tentang outsourcing
gitu. Iya iya iya. Oh pernah kenal ya?
Iya iya pernah kenal. Kita ajak. Saya ajak.
Oh iya iya.
Banyak masalah yang belum selesai. Banyak yang tadi sampaikan juga tentang terutama union busting,
bagaimana
pekerja Indonesia itu sangat sulit untuk mendirikan serikat pekerja atau bergabung kepada serikat pekerja PR, kemudian juga banyak juga upah yang belum dibayarkan sesuai dengan undang-undang minimum wage tidak dibayarkan, kemudian sosial kesehatan kata negara wajib ternyata belum juga diikutsertakan jaminan kesehatan, malah di PHK, jadi banyak kasus masuk dan mungkin perlu pentingnya peran parlemen juga mendorong pemerintah dalam ini Kementerian Tenaga Kerja untuk bisa menyelesaikan ini bersama-sama, jadi bukan hanya diserahkan kepada antara lembaga serikat tidak yang dengan perusahaan, tapi kita butuh kehadiran pemerintah negara dalam hal ini untuk bersama-sama menyelesaikan masalahnya gini mas, dinas tenaga kerja terutama daerah itu tidak efektif, belum maksimal. Kalau di nasional kan mungkin sudah penuh ya, dan kita tidak semua tidak mesti harus semua nasional menyelesaikan. Tapi bagaimana daerah ini juga mengefektifkan, memaksimalkan kinerja mereka untuk sama-sama mengawal, memonitor persoalan buruh di Indonesia. Ini yang persoalan-persoalan yang belum sampai sekarang belum tertangani
di daerah terutama.
Di daerah terutama di daerah. Daerah itu maksudnya level kabupaten itu mas. Depok, Bekasi, Cirebon, gitu, Purwakarta. Kalau Jakarta mungkin udah inilah ya, mudah gitu ya, ada dirjen langsung reaksi. Tapi kalau Kasudin ya, kepala dinas itu yang belum dia memaksimalkan tenaga, terutama tenaga pengawas, tenaga pengawas tenaga kerjaan yang kita tidak malah ada yang nggak kompeten di situ. Ada yang mantan tugas kuburan, jadi terlalu dia nggak paham banget ketika ada permasalahan.
Now they are moved to the labor.
Kami hadir di sini, ini unit global ini menggunakan cara sosial partnership, sosial dialog. Saya juga heran kenapa Eropa menggunakan musyawarah mufakat dalam memilih level-level presidennya, sekjennya. Tapi kalau di kita, melalui kongres, ketika nggak kepilih, pecah. Ya, ngambek, dirin federasi. Gitu loh. Nggak kepilih jadi presiden, bubar dirin federasi. Kalau ini malah nggak. Musyawarah mufakat.
So di global ya khususnya.
Dari voting, bagaimana dia musyawarah mufakat. Ini lucu, lucu. Eropa sendiri ngajarin musyawarah mufakat, Indonesia enggak. Nah ini yang mungkin bisa kita tiru, dan Indonesia akan meniru itu, ya, dan memang kita mengusung sosial partnership, sosial dialog.
Okay, Mbak Mira, terima kasih atas ini ya, sama Mas Abda dari Sekjen. Oke, okay, ini menarik sekali bahwa sebagai pimpinan sektor jasa,
so as leaders of the
datang ke saya untuk membicarakan soal bagaimana kolaborasi
dan discussion about the collaboration
others. Ya, tentu saja.
Yes.
Sudah menjadi kewajiban kami anggota parlemen
untuk
mendorong legislasi yang berpihak. Makanya Dina sebagai staf saya di sini juga banyak koneksi dengan serikat buruh,
so that's why
juga mendorong ada legislasi soal dispute settlement. Ini adalah contoh bahwa
law of the industrial relations dispute settlement.
Dan kalau memang kami, saya dalam bekerja, dalam menempatkan staff saya bukan cuma ada di sini, tapi terutama di
all my staff,
social movement, untuk berkoneksi dengan union, koneksi dengan gerakan petani, koneksi dengan social movement yang lain. Karena staff saya, saya pikir tidak terlalu baik dibutuhkan di kantor, tapi bagaimana
networking.
Ini dalam rangka merespon apa yang Mbak Mira katakan soal social partnership. Saya pikir keberadaan saya di DPR ini hanya salah satu dot titik saja dari sebuah massive network. Meskipun saya mau saya tidak langsung berhubungan dengan isu perburuhan, tapi saya dengan jejaring lewat staff saya bekerja dengan berbagai macam, termasuk dengan jaringan buruh. Saya kira pas sekali untuk social partnership dan social dialog. Apalagi dikatakan tadi bahwa pekerjaan di sektor jasa akan merebak dengan perkembangan IT dan informasi, digital ekonomi, sektor jasa akan ada di depan dari segi kuantiti dan juga signifikansinya, the significance of
the sector.
Kebetulan saya dengan Dina dan staff saya juga banyak melakukan network hal ini dengan desa untuk membangun digital ekonomi di desa-desa yang membuat badan usaha milik desa village oleh enterprises, di mana share-nya oleh rakyat desa sendiri, tapi teruskan melibatkan pekerja desa.
So
salah satu yang sudah ada contoh yang sudah kita lakukan di Lampung,
is in Lampung.
Ada satu pertambakan udang, biggest one in Southeast Asia. Dan 85% dividennya dimiliki oleh pekerja setempat.
And the owner is
pekerja dan penduduk,
the owner of this
populasi
business,
dan pekerja dan this. Juga dari kita. Nah, kita ingin menjadikannya sebuah model.
Untuk
kita lakukan di seluruh desa di Indonesia, di seluruh kabupaten
Indonesia, in Indonesia.
Dan sedang kita lakukan itu, jadi menciptakan sosial. Kalau tadi Mira mata sosial partnership, kita ingin menciptakan social enterprises.
So we build the social entrepreneurs.
Dan saya juga dengan tim saya sudah mengajukan legislasi undang-undang national entrepreneurship.
The law on of
social. Dan kita akan mencantumkan nomenklatur tentang social enterprise sebagai satu bentuk
the social enterprise
perusahaan yang harus hadir di Indonesia,
and it should
jadi nanti dia harus dominan dalam jumlahnya dan terutama untuk di lokal distrik atau sampai desa. Dan
local
social enterprise kita harapkan menjadi satu jenis perusahaan yang akan paling banyak menyerap tenaga kerja.
Jika
pemilikan saham oleh buruh, territorially based, di desa-desa atau di antar desa,
and also
antar desa untuk menciptakan scale ekonomi, economic scale, fokus ke 147 badan usaha milik desa,
47 village
satu kabupaten,
enterprises
in satu kabupaten,
district,
dan dengan bersama 5 badan usaha milik antar desa, di mana kita akan membuat sebuah konsep tentu ini kita bawa ke level nasional. Nanti kita inginkan di desa,
so in village.
Yang 100% pekerja,
100%
100% pemilik, dan dari mereka lah manajemen.
100%
di sini kita akan, karena desa masih sekitar dari
250
juta rakyat Indonesia, itu sekitar 150 juta adalah orang desa.
Maka
kalau kita kerja benar, aspek akan kerja masuk ke desa-desa, saya pikir ke depan aspek masuk ke kota-kota kecil
to the village,
menengah, kota because kecil dan desa, maka aspek akan bisa punya network ke union di kalangan sub-district sampai down to village
city, but also big also in the village.
Tentu saja di desa bukan cuma service sector, juga di manufacturer kita akan buat juga tentu saja.
My aim also not only
kita terinspirasi oleh beberapa pembangunan desa di Tiongkok misalnya,
so we learn
atau di Israel ada kibbutz namanya yang bagaimana pemilikan itu, sekarang kita akan buat dengan model badan usaha milik desa. Saya kira itu sudah. Jadi saya pikir aspek nanti lewat dinas staff saya, dia juga ngurusi desa, dia ngurusi IT di desa. Nanti dengan Labda coba gabung bagaimana aspek mencoba masuk ke dalam desa dan kemudian berbicara soal unionisasi dari terutama service sector di desa. Yang sedang kita lakukan dalam waktu 2-3 tahun ke depan.
We are trying to do in the next 3 years.
Yang lain juga kita akan lagi mencoba untuk melakukan proses kerja melakukan IT-nisasi,
jadi
memasukkan IT ke sekitar 30.000 desa
to the 30,000 villages
untuk
digitally connected.
For digitally connected.
Sebagai satu dalam 3 tahun ke depan dan mudah-mudahan kita akan lakukan.
All the regulation will.
Di situ akan banyak kerja service sektor terutama di bidang sektor teknologi. Ya, silakan bersama dengan Dika nanti. Lewat Mbak Dina.
Ya,
Mas Kul Mbak Dina.
Oke.
Ya.
Very good. Yes. So we want to thank you once again.
You are welcome.
That,
yeah.
That you, you have.
Maybe we can learn also from Pam from Finlandia.
And in that purpose.
Oh, that's cool.
We have.
I like the title.
We have social innovations.
Tell us a lot. Yeah. Tell us a lot.
And the, here is only the fraction of them. It's only 100.
Oh, okay. That's cool. But maybe it will inspire us to make. Not 100, but 74,000 innovations because we have 74,000 villages.
Okay.
So it's villages, they create their own innovation.
Okay.
Well, right. Thank you.
Thank you very much for meeting.
This is the kind of book that we will need most now to push people, to encourage people to make innovation.
Yeah, let's hope you get good ideas.
Social
from
credit, okay. Bilingualism, student accommodation.
Yeah, it's sort of a combination of articles.
Oh, yes. Okay. All this right. Is put in the constitution. Okay, thank you.
Yes, all right, thank you.